Now I'm going to talk to you about some of the exciting changes we're making in version 9 of Historian that comes out at the end of this year. And one of the areas we focused on is simplification and reduction in effort in terms of configuring, managing, and maintaining our system. And specifically around collectors, we are building a whole new set of capabilities that are going to really simplify your life as it comes to installing collectors and configuring them and managing them. So first, our collector configuration or installation process will be dramatically simplified. No more difficult and challenging and technical questions when you want to install collectors. If you go to install collectors on a machine, it'll be just a quick dump all of the collectors onto that machine, and then you'll have a new configuration experience to configure those collectors. So you'll be able to create instances either from that node or even better, from the central historian node. You'll be able to connect in to the central archiver and be able to reach into any and all of the nodes that have collectors on them that are connected to the central server. And that's all enabled by a remote collector agent that we released in version 8.1. The agent goes on every collector machine, and the historian archiver talks to the agent, and the agent talks to all of the collectors, including allowing you to configure collectors and create new instances of new collectors on those machines. So simplifying that effort. And beyond that, we're giving you the ability to actually take actions on the regarding the collectors on those remote servers. So you don't have to RDP in, you don't have to go to site, which might have to happen in some cases. And sometimes our customers have collectors deployed at their customer sites anywhere around the world. And so if there's a problem with a collector, solving that problem today is time costly. It can be expensive. So now we're going to give you the ability from the central administrator to be able to interact with those remote collectors in a new way. And I'm going to show you that here in a demo system. So all of you are probably familiar with the Historian Administrator. And here you can see I'm running on server Win 2019 DJ1. I've got three collectors running on this machine, and I've got two remote collectors. Now I'm going to toggle over to what the new user experience is going to look like with respect to collectors. So now here's the system properties for my current system. I'm going to click on collectors. I see the five collectors, and now this is a super modern interface, HTML5 based. If I want to drag and drop columns because that's the way I want to see it, I'll be able to do that. So now I'm sorting by, I can sort or I can filter. So many of our customers, they might have 1,000 collectors pointing to a given server. Really much simpler way of interacting. And now I'm going to do a quick demonstration. So remember, I'm on Win 2019 DJ1. And so sure, I could start and stop a collector. But what's now neat is I can do that on a remote server. So I've selected this OPC server. I'm going to now click on actions, and you see that I could start and stop a server. I could restart a server, which is basically a bounce. I could pause data collection. I can move or clear buffer files. I can even change the destination server, which would allow me to maybe during startup, I'm pointing a collector to a QA server and I move to production mode and I want to point the data and have the data stream to a production server. So lots of thought have gone into the kinds of actions we can take. You'll also happen to notice here that you can see the version of the collectors that's running. That wasn't something that was easy or possible before. So we've added new REST commands to that agent we can interact with, and we can now see and do a lot more things than we've been able to do in the past. So I'm going to go ahead here. I have a running collector. I'm going to hit start. It's going to provide me some information. If I needed to, because of security, I needed to provide credentials, I could do so. You see that it's running on this machine. It's running in service mode. So I'm going to go ahead and just issue a stop command. And so I'll get a message that that stop has been initiated. If I toggle back over here to my old administrator, we'll be able to see that stopped. So everything's interacting the way we would think. Now that I see that OPC collector running on HistWin 2016 one has been stopped, I could do other actions. I could restart it. I could move buffer files. So think about it, at times maybe buffer files have gotten too large. You could just move them into another directory or onto another disk. I could clear the buffer files. If I think the buffer files have gotten corrupted, I can remotely clear those to make the collector start running again. And I can change the destination server. Let's go ahead and do the move buffer function. And just so that you see what that looks like. So it's going to allow me to enter in a new location to move the data to. Again, it would allow me to enter in username and password, and it shows me what sort of mode that collector's running in. So it's currently not running, but it would be running. It's configured to run in command line mode. I hope that that's given you a glimpse into the kinds of new capabilities we're giving and our new user experience around interacting with Historian, new Historian capabilities as we go forward into release 9.0.